From stolen diamonds to rare fossils, here are 15 extremely valuable treasures that no one can find. Number 15, the Graff Diamonds Robbery. This story of lost treasure happened on the premises of Graff Diamonds in London in 2009. Lawrence Graff was known to collect the world's most magnificent diamonds and would sell them at auction. Two sharply dressed men posing as customers stole jewelry valued at more than $65 million. The haul included more than 40 items, including wristwatches, rings, bracelets, and a single necklace worth nearly $5.25 million. At the time, this was one of Britain's largest ever gem heists. The robbers were caught shortly afterwards, but none of the stolen items were ever recovered. The best guess is that the precious gems were recut and then sold anonymously. While four people involved are in jail, it was a confusing case, as one of the men said that he was forced into it by a man known as Kev and the Big Boss. The bosses who planned this robbery remain at large. Number 14, the Elysian Park Treasure. Founded in 1886, this is the oldest park in Los Angeles, and encompassing more than 600 acres, or 2.5 square kilometers, it's among the largest as well. Stories of buried treasure have been linked to the park since at least the late 19th century. In 1896, an article about the search for gold was published about the wealthy cattle rancher Francisco Avila, who is said to have buried $100,000 in coins and jewels, as he was afraid of bandits. He buried the treasure along with a friend. After he died, only his wife knew the location, and she passed it on to a young girl, who told others to help her find it, but they never did. During the Mexican-American War, many other people are thought to have buried their treasure. Wealthy families were said to have buried gold and other valuables within the park's canyons to keep their fortunes safe. Many of those families may not have returned for their riches, or the secret hiding places may have been forgotten over time. Various sources claim that dugout tunnels have been located there, along with stones bearing curious markings. Who knows, maybe those are clues. It is illegal to dig there without a permit, so plan your quest accordingly. Number 13, Peking Man. These fossils were located in China during the 1920s and were dated to about 750,000 years ago. The partial skeleton was an example of Homo erectus and is regarded as a human ancestor. The fossils were stored in Peking at the Union Medical College. In 1941, they were shipped to the American Museum of Natural History in New York City, but they disappeared en route and never arrived at the destination. Various attempts have been undertaken to find the fossils, but they've all been unsuccessful. Some sources think the disappearance was intentional, while others think the fossils were a fabrication. What do you think? Let us know in the comments below. And now for number 12, but first, be sure to subscribe if you haven't already, and let us know which treasure you would want to find in the comments below. Number 12, the Florentine Diamond. This gem was known by several other names, including the Tuscany Diamond. Weighing more than 137 carats, or 27.5 grams, it was often regarded as the world's largest gem of its kind, but its origins were always disputed. According to some accounts, it was a rough stone from India. That version states that the Grand Duke of Tuscany acquired it sometime in the 17th century. It was later passed to Empress Maria Theresa of Austria and placed in the Habsburg crown jewels. When the Austrian Empire fell, the exiled rulers took it with them to Switzerland. It disappeared in 1918 and was never seen again. The prevailing theory goes that a person close to the royal family took the gem to South America with other valuables. Number 11, Da Vinci's Lost Mural. This painting is sometimes called the Lost Leonardo. Formerly known as the Battle of Anghiari, it depicted the victory of the Florence-led Italian League over their rival Milan in 1440. It was displayed in the Palazzo Vecchio, or Town Hall, in Florence in the early 16th century. But it disappeared in 1563, when the building was remodeled. In 2012, a group of art experts claimed that the painting might still exist within the hall, but was covered up by a subsequent fresco. The recovery effort was discontinued later that year due to disagreements between the experts. Number 10, the Lost Dutchman's Mine. Many experts regard this as the most famous lost gold mine in U.S. history. Legend has it that it's hidden in Arizona's Superstition Mountains east of Phoenix. It's named for a German immigrant named Jacob Waltz, who kept its location a secret after finding it in the 19th century. Treasure hunters have been seeking the location since at least 1892, and according to some estimates, some 8,000 people try to find the mine every year. Along the way, some adventurers have met violent ends, but so far, no one has uncovered this treasure. Number 9. The Copper Scroll Treasures. In 1952, an ancient scroll was discovered at the West Bank at the ancient archaeological site of Qumran. What made this scroll unique was that it wasn't made from parchment. It was crafted from alloyed copper to ensure it lasted. Dated to about 70 CE, it's one of the Dead Sea Scrolls, but it doesn't contain a literary effort. There are various locations inscribed that theoretically indicate where huge amounts of gold and silver could be stashed away. Archaeologists think the copper scroll was hidden by locals to keep it away from the Romans during the times of rebellion against the empire. It's been on display at the Jordan Museum of Amman since 2013. Number 8. The Amber Room. Before it was lost, many people regarded this as an eighth wonder of the world. It was constructed during the 18th century in Prussia, and was later installed at the Berlin City Palace in Germany. About 13,000 pounds of amber, almost 6 metric tons, were used to create the panels that adorned the chamber. Gold-gilded mosaics, mirrors, and carvings were also found there. The German army looted the Amber Room in the 1940s. During that time, the room's art and panels were disassembled and shipped to Germany for construction. After that, the Amber Room was never seen again. But a replica was created, which opened to the public in 2003. It's located in the Catherine Palace, south of St. Petersburg, in Russia. Number 7. The Tomb of Genghis Khan. When he died in 1227 CE, he reigned over the largest contiguous empire in the history of the world. Before his death, the Great Khan requested to be buried without any markings or identification. His body was taken to Mongolia and presumably interred near his birthplace in the eastern part of the country. Legend has it that some 30,000 people were involved with his funereal process, which may have included the placement of a tomb. Those workers, along with anyone else who knew the burial site's location, were all executed. The burial site has still never been located, but whoever discovers the tomb of Genghis Khan might discover a valuable dividend. Some researchers think that the ruler was buried with a great assortment of riches. Number 6. Oak Island Money Pit. If you're a fan of The Curse of Oak Island on the History Channel, then this segment might sound like a repeat. For those of you unfamiliar with this mysterious treasure, take heed. In other words, pay attention. Oak Island is found in Canada, off of Nova Scotia. For more than two centuries, rumors have swirled that all manner of treasures are located here. That includes everything from original Shakespearean manuscripts to the jewels of Marie Antoinette. The infamous pirate William Kidd is speculated to have buried booty that was worth millions of dollars. Early explorers called the original excavation site the Money Pit, and that name persists to the 21st century. Although efforts have been ongoing since the 1800s, no significant treasure has ever been located. But as the title of the TV show alludes, there is a curse associated with Oak Island. It states that 7 men will perish before the treasure is recovered. At last count, 6 men have died while trying to find it. Number 5. Antony and Cleopatra's Tomb. According to ancient writings, Cleopatra VII and Mark Antony were buried together in a tomb following their deaths. Plutarch, the Greek biographer and essayist, wrote that the tomb could be found near a temple of the Egyptian goddess Isis. It was described as a beautiful monument, made of treasures like gold, silver, emeralds, and pearls. In 2010, excavations were conducted at a site near Alexandria, Egypt, at a temple of Osiris. 27 tombs of Egyptian nobles, along with artifacts depicting Antony and Cleopatra, have been located in the vicinity. But the tomb has yet to be located. Excavations continue, but have advised caution. Even if Cleopatra's tomb did survive to the 21st century, it might be unidentifiable at this point. That's because it may have been pillaged and looted over the ages. Number 4. The Lost Treasure of Lima. A fortune estimated at more than $200 million was removed from Lima, Peru in 1820. The huge treasure had been accumulated by the Roman Catholic Church since the 1500s. When Lima was teetering on the edge of revolt, the city had to be evacuated. That led the church officials to transport treasures, including jewels and gold statues, to Mexico for safekeeping. But after the items were loaded on board a vessel, the ship's crew and captain turned pirate and sailed off to Cocos Island near Costa Rica. That's where they allegedly buried the treasure. The crew was later caught and executed, except for the captain and the first mate. They agreed to lead the Spanish back to Cocos Island to recover the treasure, but the two escaped into the jungle, so the exact location was never revealed. Despite the efforts of countless adventurers, the treasure remains lost. Number 3. The Ark of the Covenant. Aside from Indiana Jones, archaeologists still can't puzzle out what happened to this legendary artifact. It was said to be held in Jerusalem when the city was conquered in 587 BCE by the Babylonians. The army sacked the city and destroyed the first temple, in which the Ark was allegedly stored. But history is unclear as to what happened to the Ark. Some ancient sources claim it was hidden prior to the city's invasion, or carried back to Babylon, and it's possible that it was destroyed during the conflict. Stories and legends have since grown concerning the fate of the Ark. Some of the more popular theories claim that the Ark somehow made its way to Ethiopia, where today it is stored and guarded in a treasury. Number 2. Flor de la Mar. Translated from the Portuguese as the Flower of the Sea, this was a 16th century sailing vessel, weighing some 800,000 pounds, or 363 metric tons. It played an important role in maritime events in the Indian Ocean for nearly a decade. When it sat off the coast of Malaysia in 1511, the ship was purportedly carrying a huge treasure trove for the Portuguese monarch. Unlike a lot of legends involving lost riches, Flor de la Mar's valuables had been documented after they were looted from a sultan's palace in Malacca. But that doesn't provide a treasure map. The ship was caught in a storm and sank near Sumatra. All the cargo was hopelessly lost, and today the ship still remains unrecovered on the sea floor. Attempts at locating are complicated because Indonesia, Portugal, and Malaysia have all claimed salvage rights. Number 1. A criminal fortune. He died in 1935, but Dutch Schultz is still considered one of the most notorious mobsters in U.S. history. At the time, there was money to be made in bootlegging alcohol. As the FBI was closing in on him, Schultz feared he would be incarcerated, so he had a special airtight and waterproof safe constructed, into which he sealed $7 million in cash and bonds. Along with an associate, he drove to an undisclosed location in upstate New York and had the safe buried. It's believed to be somewhere in the Catskill Mountains, where locals say they saw men wearing fedoras and carrying shovels. While he was arrested, no jury could convict him. At the time he died, the safe wouldn't have been moved because neither Schultz nor his associate were thought to have shared its location. While it's still the object of many treasure hunters, the safe has never been recovered. But if someone does find it, they're in for an epic payday. That $7 million stash would today be worth more than $130 million, adjusted for inflation. While he led a very colorful life, a life of crime doesn't pay, and he died at the age of 33 from a gunshot wound. Thanks for watching this episode. Did you like the video? Tell us what you think in the comments below, and be sure to like, follow, and subscribe.